It's been 3 days since Afghanistan's capital fell to the Taliban. Since then, hundreds of people have been camped out at the airport hoping for a way to get out of the country. And joining me now to discuss just that further is Dr. Carol Lieberman. Dr. Lieberman, what are some sentiments that you are hearing from some of your patients when it comes to the images that we're seeing out of Afghanistan?
The images are heartbreaking. This is such a travesty on so many different levels. The political level, how our allies are going to trust the United States that if we come in to save them from whatever problem, that we're going to stick by them. There are so many other political issues, but also on a personal level, on you know, as far as the American people are concerned. It's like the bottom fell out, you know, the pride in our country, the feeling that America, you know, I'm not saying that the war should have happened or shouldn't have happened, but think about the people who joined the military after 9/11, with such courage in their hearts, and so many people died and so many people got injured, and now they you know, come out in this hasty, unplanned, horrible fashion that all is lost. Like, they're asking themselves, and the family of those who died are asking themselves, you know, why did we lose our brother or our father or whoever, for nothing, for just to go out and have accomplished nothing? And you know, these pictures that we're seeing now of all the people running to get on the plane, sure, most of them are Afghans who, you know, don't want the Taliban and so on. But do you think that there aren't any terrorists in there who are also amongst that group of people who, when they get to the United States, are going to present a danger? Absolutely.
And some of the comments that I have read online basically say, if you would have told anyone after 9/11 that we would ultimately be arming the enemy, they would not believe it for 1 second. What is your reaction to that? Because that's ultimately what we did.
Yes, they have taken so many of our weapons and so on. You know, now they're so much stronger than ever. And you know, let me just say, I'm a born and bred New Yorker. And when 9/11 happened, although I was already living in California, I decided to devote a portion of my career, my work, to helping people cope with terrorism, the memory of 9/11, as well as the ongoing threat of terrorism. And so I've written 2 books about terrorism. I do a podcast, I call myself the Terrorist Therapist, and I do a podcast by that name. And I have been trying to keep people aware of the ongoing threat, and so that people will make themselves more resilient and so on. The only positive coming out of this, and it's, you know, I say positive in single quotes, is that the celebration or the commemoration of 9/11 every year in these 20 years has gotten less and less. People want to forget about it. You know, they don't want to think it can ever happen again, of course, so they want to push this bad memory out of their mind. Now, at least, there will be more recognition. He who forgets history is doomed to repeat it. So there is more of a reason, not just, of course, honoring the people who died, the first responders and so on, but also so that we keep our guard up and realize that this is not over. There are still terrorists out there who have planned for over 1,000 years to take over the West with Sharia law. And so at least it's a reminder that we really do need to pay attention to this.
And Dr. Lieberman, talk about the mental anguish, because we are just a few weeks out from the 20 years since 9/11, and all this is happening. Yeah.
Yes, you know, I mean, it's so ironic, so tragic. You know, we have been, as we get closer to the 20th anniversary, all of us have had some sense of awareness. You know, it's a sense of dread, really, of coming to that day and you know, having to remember and all these painful memories. We all know where we were and those kinds of things. And so now this, of course, is adding to it and adding to our fear, adding to our anxiety, you know, adding to a sadness. It's really a sadness, the loss. You know, when 9/11 happened, another possible good thing is that when 9/11 happened, after it, the country came together. All the divisions, the various kinds of divisions, were forgotten in our patriotism for America. And hopefully that will happen again now. But it's just this feeling, this pride, is so shaken when we walk out or run out with our tail between our legs. Those pictures are awful.
Yeah, absolutely. And Dr. Lieberman, it is worth mentioning. I do have to wrap after this. We were united, but it just seemed our target shifted. So that is also worth mentioning as well. Thank you so much for joining us. It's always a pleasure having you on BNC Live.